I'm surprised that over the past 2 years, no one has asked me for details of the brainwashing that I was subjected to in 1982 by the witch, aka the snake lady. And no one asked me how DIA prepared me to survive known communist brainwashing techniques using MKULTRA in 1981, as stated in my websites. I've been asked a lot of questions, but never either of those. No one asked for details of the brainwashing that I was subjected to in 1982 by the witch, and no one asked me how DIA prepared me to survive known communist brainwashing techniques using MKULTRA in 1981. It's time I disclose some details. I've been out here 2.5 years. One effect of today's video is that some people at DIA and CIA will know that I'm telling the truth, because I am describing a hitherto classified known communist brainwashing technique. I put this here for the people too, although I don't expect many to believe it or understand me. Previously, I reported specific details of the brainwashing to General Henry Shelton in 1998, who was chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff then. I've mentioned that a few times. I also mentioned that my 1999 federal lawsuit provided phone records showing communications to General Shelton's direct office line, in addition to a crooked court system there. As stated elsewhere, DIA prepared me to survive known communist brainwashing techniques using MKULTRA in 1981. I've already covered why DIA wanted me to try that in the first two links I posted. And there's two other related posts. Why I am a targeted individual part 1 ancestry, did a video on that. Why I'm a targeted individual part 2, targeted Round Lake students, video on that too. This first image is taken from the internet. Some artist rendering of MKULTRA participants at a CIA installation. That's fairly close to some of what I experienced in 1981. Except there was only one of those chairs in the room and no CIA logo on the floor. I want to point out that the CIA's old Waukegan office in Lake County in 1981 was only a couple of miles from Great Lakes Naval Base, which was a fully active base at that time. Now these screens show a couple pictures of Dr. M.A. Persinger's God helmet, and I did a video on that. This God helmet is just FYI. It's one of many examples of the use of electromagnetic energy to screw with people's minds. C-23 U.S. patented mind control related devices 1956 to 2003. And I've got some other materials on my website and list of videos. I'm not going into specifics about DIA's techniques. The focus is the techniques used by the witch in 1982. And I'm not even going into that much detail on that here today. In December 1982, I was attending the College of Lake County part-time and working as an editor on a student newspaper. There were several personal crises affecting me at the time, which I'm not getting into. And I was temporarily staying over at my grandmother's house in Trevor, Wisconsin, which was located 1.66 miles from the witch's Rock Lake, Wisconsin house, where she was there, aka the snake lady, to little children in Antioch, the teenagers. One evening in December of 82, I received a phone call from the witch. I hadn't seen her for more than a year, actually closer to 2 years, I believe. She invited me to a party at her house that night. Today, I don't have any question in my mind as to how I could have forgotten that Miller, the witch, had tried to have me killed twice in the past. Memory erasure is possible by chemical or microwave frequencies. It's not a theory. I have a page on that, the secret government's ability to erase memory. Not the only one telling you this stuff. And keep in mind that the military generally has technology 20 to 30 years before the technology becomes public knowledge. Memory erasure is possible, without even considering that MKUltra was involved in my case. If I had remembered that the witch had put contracts out on me twice, I wouldn't have accepted her invitation. And what happened here is DIA wanted me to make contact, so they relieved me of those memories in 1981, since I couldn't even trust myself to not kill Miller before DIA's investigation concluded. I'm not making this full-blown account of the events on the night in December 82. and I'm not going to disclose as much as I told General Shelton. At some point of the witch's party, she handed me a gin bottle, and I drank some. And I was affected strangely. Today I realized I was drugged, obviously. The next thing I knew, I found myself standing with a group of mostly women, and Miller was in front of us performing some satanic mumbo jumbo at her goddamn altar. I noticed the missing crown of Liechtenstein on the witch's goddamn altar. The CIA had had an earlier report prior to me coming along in 1981 that the witch might have the missing crown of Liechtenstein, but the person who reported it was killed before he was able to confirm it. When I saw the missing crown of Liechtenstein, it triggered my memory. I have a page, Why Devil Worshippers Have the Missing Crown of Liechtenstein. According to the Liechtenstein records, according to their beliefs at the time, the missing crown of Liechtenstein was designed as a shield against evil and poisons. It should be pretty obvious why devil worshippers like to have the missing crown of Liechtenstein. I have never been a devil worshipper. And as noted in a post about Round Lake MKUltra survivors of the Witches Network, prior to this night in 82, I had never seen any evidence of witchcraft, and she had denied involvement in such activity when I asked her about it when I first heard her called the witch, just after I knew her for a while. And there was also a woman up at the head of the class, as I'll call it, with the witch, seated facing us. Supposedly the witch had performed some spell which had turned the woman into a host for some demon or some bullshit. And then that damn woman, speaking as if she was some demon, demanded tribute from everyone present. That damn woman demanded that I make an offering. Now I didn't know what she meant by that. She wanted me to jack off in front of her. Miller told me what she meant by offering. I refused. The others who were present, who must have been regulars, broke out into fear as the thing at the head of the class began uttering all sorts of threats and nonsense. Miller kissed their ass quick and then came up to me to try to convince me to do it. I told her that I was leaving. Then Miller grabbed me in her arms. I struggled with Miller. Then I broke free by putting her on her ass. Then the last thing I saw was that damn fake demon woman rush up to me with some sort of canister in her hands. And I saw a white cloud of smoke like gas as it hit me. I was immobilized almost instantaneously. I started falling to the floor, and as I was blacking out, Miller caught me and said to me, "Good night, motherfucker." When I returned to my grandma's house and what I thought was the next morning, my grandma was very upset, and she told me I had been gone for 3 days. I didn't believe her, and I told her she was wrong. So my grandma phoned my mom and had me take the phone. My mom told me the same thing, that my grandma had been calling her for days looking for me, and that I had been gone 3 days. I didn't believe my mom either, and so it was a mystery to my family, and I had no memory of what had been done to me until my memory was first triggered in 1995. The next thing I knew after being gassed, I woke up strapped down to a gurney, or some kind of a little table or something. I could feel that I was naked, and there was a man in Miller standing to my right side. I could move my head, and I saw strange black writing all over my body. Some kind of devil spell shit. The man was known to DIA as the Bulgarian, and told me that the communists thought he was the Hungarian, Lieutenant Colonel Karol Laszlo, Hungarian military attaché to the Hungarian embassy, expelled in 1961 for attempting to acquire manufacturing information, including in the Chicagoland area. As I was regaining consciousness, the Bulgarian and Miller began to argue in a foreign language. It sounded Slavic to me. Then the Bulgarian injected me with something. I woke up again. I was still on the gurney, and I was alone with the Bulgarian. He was frantic, and he injected me with something again. I woke up again. We were alone again. And the Bulgarian had a look of fear on his face, great fear. And he asked me, "Why don't you stay dead?" Then Miller came rushing into the room and injected me with something. And that knocked me out. When the Bulgarian had the chance to, he told me that he had tried to convince Miller that I was dead. But I woke up twice and jeopardized his position with the communists. The Bulgarian was actually a triple agent working for the US. I discussed that elsewhere in my websites. The Bulgarian also told me that he had argued with Miller about washing off the devil writing before he would work on me. Eventually he got his way. The Bulgarian told me that he hoped that washing off those spells would help me survive. He told me he had seen some things in it. He was actually afraid of these people. The Bulgarian attempted to sabotage the brainwashing. The Bulgarian had prepared for the anticipated brainwashing. Yeah, it was coming. In addition to all the data and programming that he prepared, he also brought some drugs that would help counteract certain phases of the brainwashing, the techniques of which were already known to DIA in 1981. The Bulgarian also brought some memory drugs. Using some of the drugs he smuggled past Miller, the Bulgarian created several instances where he woke me up during brainwashing stages, which caused aborts to those stages and made me remember them when my memory was later triggered in 1995, so I could confirm certain things for DIA, so that DIA could pinpoint the time. The Bulgarian told me that he had just killed the last of the chemists before he went to Miller's house. I did see some electronic equipment at various stages of the process when I was awake. I recall some kind of electric contact pads on me at times too. I'm feeling that. After Miller injected me following the Bulgarian's second failed attempt to fake my death, the next thing I knew I woke up in a chair and I was tied or strapped to the chair. All I could see was a blue display screen with text on it, and my head was encased in something. Then I heard a voice ask me if I could see the words. When I answered yes, he told me to read it. It was a story about a boy. As I read it, I realized it was about me, and the writer had known far too much personal information. I finished reading the story on the screen in front of me, which was all that I had to look at. I'm only going to mention that the ending of the story was quite unpleasant. He asked me if I was done reading. It must have been obvious there was some physical reaction I was done. I said yes. Then he told me to read it again. The Bulgarian told me to read that story over and over again. And each time he told me to read it again, the volume of his voice got louder and louder until it was deafening. That went on until my mind snapped. That's one way to break into a mind using MKULTRA technology that existed in 1982. The next thing that I knew, my head was still encased and I was looking at more shit to read. Specifically, I could feel something over my head, covering eyes and ears, and also strapped under my chin. I tried to shake the damn thing off my head like a dog, but that didn't work. It was fastened too securely. I also bit a couple of the Bulgarian's fingers when his hands got too close, testing the tightness of the rig. Although I couldn't see, I had my other senses. I sensed fingers and I got them. This time there was no painful voice when the session resumed. These were the information sessions. The Bulgarian layered my consciousness using some of those drugs and other techniques typical of MKUltra, and pretty much as DIA had done with me in 1981, because they layered me too, only it wasn't like invasive like this shit was. Instead of doing what Miller thought he was doing, the Bulgarian only did what portion of Miller's agenda that he absolutely had to do in order for me to pass the final chemical questioning by Miller. Both of our lives depended on me passing that questioning session. So instead of doing what all Miller wanted, the Bulgarian gave me all the information that he had about the communist and Illuminati long-range plans. Yes, I said both sides. I was presented with text and graphics on a light blue background. It was still expected that DIA would at the very least pick me up for my confirmations in 10 to 15 years, and the Bulgarian had plans to trigger my memory too in case DIA failed to do that, and to put DIA onto the trail of what Miller did to me and what all else was connected to this. At one point, the Bulgarian had a chance to wake me up when Miller went somewhere. The Bulgarian showed me a device that had been used on me. It looked similar to an old airman's cap. Now, these illustrations are just crude, but you should get the idea. Now, that headgear was not at all like DIA's equipment. Not at all. DIA's technique to enter my subconscious was not invasive, and there was only minimal pain. If the Bulgarian had not been present to sabotage the brainwashing, I'm certain that I would have never remembered what had been done to me. The brainwashing behavior modification sessions that the witch subjected me to did not involve the use of the headgear, or none that I recall. I know that because the Bulgarian woke me up 3 times during sessions that the witch needed him to participate in. The Bulgarian pricked my ear so that I would leave a blood stain inside the headgear so that DIA could have that evidence on Miller too. According to the Bulgarian, that headgear unit was hers, assigned to her, and the witch couldn't lose it or ask for a replacement. The Bulgarian claimed he had been sent for to handle certain phases of the brainwashing only because of his expertise. Otherwise, Miller would have used one of her own team to assist her with the particular session she wanted done. Eventually, Miller did bring her own help after the 3 failures which happened with the Bulgarian. The Bulgarian told me that when he woke me up and showed me the headgear while Miller was gone somewhere. And I do, in fact, remember at least one other person, a female, that was involved. And no, it wasn't the crazy demon woman from the head of the class. I've mentioned that headgear before in a post, plus the blood stain, and I made a graphic for it. There's a lot more to the story of the brainwashing that I'm not telling here today, as well as a lot of other information. In the beginning of the post, I did say I wasn't telling all today. My account of the brainwashing has not changed since 1995, when my memory was first triggered. So that's how I came to see the Missing Crown of Liechtenstein in 1982. The Bulgarian saw the Missing Crown himself when he came to Miller's house, and he gave me his version of Miller's account of how she got her hands on the Missing Crown of Liechtenstein, and I have a page about that, how the Missing Crown came to America. When the Bulgarian had that chance to pull off the equipment, he asked me if I had noticed anything special before Miller had subdued me. The Bulgarian didn't tell me that I had seen the Missing Crown. I told him what I thought I had seen. And then we decided to implant that info in the deepest layer when the sessions would have to resume. And we had to hope Miller would not ask about it during the chemical questioning. In 1981, I had information sessions with DIA utilizing memory-enhancing drugs and layered consciousness. In 1982, the Bulgarian supplemented what DIA had given me. The Bulgarian gave me more information than DIA did on the real power behind the takeovers. Quite a bit. The Bulgarian told me he didn't fully trust DIA, and that neither should I. And I fucking don't. Some of the information was given to me in real time, where the page stayed until I finished. And the Bulgarian and I interact. He would ask, "Are you finished?" And then ask, "Do you understand?" before moving on to the next matter. Some of the information was memorized at faster speeds. There was no interaction, and I was not exactly conscious. The data stream was fed to me visually, like swallowing without chewing, then digested later on recall, which in my case was many years later. That's also how DIA's MKULTRA sessions were, as far as using varying speeds and levels of consciousness for implanting information for later in-depth recall, with data memorized in screens or pages. The Bulgarian was a Nazi monarch scientist and world-class spy, brought here secretly in 1947 by our Joint Chiefs of Staff to run MKULTRA. 9,000 Nazi scientists and some spies were brought here to experiment on us starting in 47. That is the origin of Project MKULTRA. That is documented, and it is old news already. My reptilian brain was also tapped in one of DIA's MKULTRA processes to make me more suitable for what they intended for me to do after 10 to 15 years in the field as a sleeper, so to speak. I do not mean that I'm reptilian. Every human being has a reptile brain. Google it. There were several particular behaviors that Miller tried to program into me. The Bulgarian sabotaged the ones that he could by administering drugs that counteracted the brainwashing drugs Miller was using on me, coupled with interrupting those sessions by waking me. Miller also tried to program response behaviors to specific electronic signals. I remember some shit. I don't want to disclose more. We do not want a bunch of people now claiming to have been subjected to something like this. I have many reasons why I held off on releasing this. So that's how I know about the New World Order, the Missing Crown of Liechtenstein, and that's a big part of why I want the Satanic New World Order dead. But what I want doesn't matter. what matters is what God wants and what he's going to have me do. Notice which character also assaulted other members of my family. I've covered that in some posts. And there were other victims from my hometown of Round Lake and neighboring areas. And especially in Antioch, the wave of teenager suicides, and she was serving up there. This is a Google Maps screenshot, latitude and longitude of the last known location of the missing crown of Liechtenstein. Thanks to the past 2.5 years of fighting this, we can be sure that it's really not going to be easy to find it. And you know what? It's not the most important thing. The most important thing is finding the people that are controlling this shit within the government. And as I said previously a few times, the witch doesn't live at that house anymore. Nobody should do anything stupid. And that's where I was subjected to the abduction and brainwashing, where I saw the missing crown on the witch's satanic altar. And that's most likely where the suspected Antioch teenage victims of the witch who committed suicide. This is most likely the house where those teenagers were brainwashed using MKULTRA to test some kind of suicide programming. We know that suicide programming has been in the mix with MKUltra for a very long time. I recently learned that I was given some misinformation in 1995. There's a definite possibility that somebody or some agency wanted to create conflict between some peoples. The party that gave me the false information in 1995 were my two best buddies at that time, whose brother worked for DIA. And it's also possible, given some facts that I know, that he was owned by NSA. And the fact that he went over to Limanova, Russia, to their old family lands, kind of makes me a little suspicious too. Anyway, there are other people and other groups who would have had an interest in creating a conflict. So I'll be addressing that. It'd be kind of nice to get to some of the truth of it here behind it. All I know for sure is that Miller had the missing crown of Liechtenstein. She had it. I saw it. She had it. How she got it. All I have is the Bulgarian's account of how she got it. So that's a part where it'd be nice to have the help of my Italian friends to try and resolve some of this. And I'm certainly not going to create a conflict for somebody. I'll give them in instead.